Hi guys, welcome to Mr. Smith's Kitchen. I don't know. I'm Brian, Mr. Smith. This is my itty bitty little kitchen. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Glad to have you. Glad you stopped by. Hope you stick around. If you're returning, as always, thanks for coming back. If you aren't new to my channel, most weeks, since I've moved, things have been a little crazy. Plus, it's the holiday season and the restaurant industry and a ton of other reasons. But anyhow, family of four, I work a full-time job, so sometimes things don't always go as planned, and this week's been one of them. So yeah, if you are returning to my channel, you watch, follow me in my videos. You know, Tuesday I had a video come out, this past Tuesday, but Wednesday and Thursday, when I normally cook and bake, didn't get a chance to do anything with that. Unfortunately, Wednesday was just a hectic day. Thursday was at work, which put me way behind on chores and stuff, so we had to take care of that. So today, we're going to do meatloaf. Now, warning, if I had a warning thing, it'd be happening right now. I still have not got my new oven yet, but it will be here. It'll be here Wednesday. I'm very excited. So you guys will get to join me for the first time I ever bake in it. First time I ever cook anything on the top of it. And just like when we first moved in here, to find out that this stove is wonky, we get to play with a brand new stove. I'm kind of excited about it. As far as this stove goes, we're going to keep it. It's going to move to the basement and be part of the basement kitchen we're getting ready to build. That's still a thing. We're trying. Time is not always a friend to me and Chris. If you don't know who Chris is, it's my wife. We also have a couple kids running around here, Abby and Sarah, which you may see on occasion or at least hear them. But tonight we're going to press our luck a little and we're going to make some meatloaf. I really want to make this meatloaf. I got the recipe from Rachel Cooks with Love, and that's her YouTube channel. Wonderful lady. Some of the best recipes out there. I've yet to find truly a horrible recipe on Facebook, but she's one of the top notches. If you get a chance, check her channel out. While I'm thinking about it, don't forget to hit the subscribe button down there somewhere. There's a notification bell right beside it in case you do want to know when my videos come out. That way we can cook together, we can bake together, we can talk about things together, do all kinds of stuff. And thumbs up, thumbs down, if you wish. Not really pressed. It's not like I'm monetized or looking to meet the top 10 in all-time YouTube views. I'm documenting. So anyhow, meatloaf. Original recipe from Rachel's with Love, which I am pretty much following her recipe to a T. I don't think there's like one thing that I don't have that she did, and that's a homemade bread, but that's okay. And this meatloaf, it looks great. You can do some variations on it, but we're going to try it verbatim on her ingredients list, other than the homemade bread part. I'm having to use regular wheat bread. But, so, let me get the camera down, and we'll start looking at what all we need. Tool-wise, you'll need a bread pan, a loaf pan, and at least a bowl, two bowls. I have more than that just because I have everything out into different bowls to show you. So, let me get down here, and we'll walk through putting this meatloaf together, and then we'll make the glaze that goes on top of it. All right. So, things we will need to make this meatloaf. I am using 2 pounds of hamburger. Now, in her recipe, she used a very lean 93.7 and an 80.20. This is a pound of 80.20 and a pound of 90.10, so it's still a leaner meat. That is just thawed, looking good. To that, here, let me rearrange this. For those that are new to my channel, this is literally all my kitchen space. So, you'll have to work with me. Now, while we're putting this together, this and the glaze, you're going to want to start preheating your oven, 350 degrees. All right, so here's what we got to do. We got the 2 pounds of hamburger. We'll come back to that in a second. In this container here, I've got 2 pieces of bread, in my case, wheat bread. You could also use white bread, breadcrumbs, crackers, whatever you have available. And it's roughly 2 cups worth of whatever. you're using. Like I said, her recipe called for a homemade bread that she makes, homemade wheat bread, but I don't have homemade wheat bread, so I'm using store-bought, which she said you could use. And then we're going to take this half a cup of milk, one half a cup of milk. I'm using whole milk. You can use 2%. This is not probably the healthiest for you, meatloaf, but, you know, and there's no way really to make it a vegetarian or a vegan that I'm aware of. I guess you could use, like, the meat substitutes and do this with it, but you still have your dairy and your bread and your eggs and stuff like that. But I think it's going to taste wonderful. If she says it tastes delicious, and she does on several occasions, I think it'll be good to try. Oop. My sidekick left. All right, so all we want to do, and that was about a half a cup of milk. We're just trying to get the bread to soak up the milk and make it moist. Just like that. Now, we've got that sitting there. We got that in there. We're just going to set that to the side. We'll play with that more in a minute. Now, the things we need to do is start building our meatloaf. All right? Give me just 1 second. I forgot a tool. I got to go get it real quick. I won't be a second. Okay, so I'm back. Missed me? I missed you. I hope you missed me as much. Things we're going to put in this, all right, are as follows. I wrote everything down, like always. If you're new to my channel, I put almost everything we cook is new to us, including me. I write it down on a notebook. If we like it, we keep it in the notebook. If we don't like it, we tear it out. All right, so first thing we're going to add to this is 1 teaspoon of parsley. Teaspoon of parsley. You get it. Turn on another light. Oh, I have all the lights on. 1 teaspoon of parsley. All right. It's dried parsley, just like you'd buy at the grocery store in a little container. Yeah, if you have fresh parsley, I'm sure you could use that too. Next thing we're going to add to it is, now if you have a seasoning you like to use in your meatloaf, that's fine. She uses her everything seasoning that she makes herself. And she has a link on her video to it, but it's essentially taco seasoning. So that's what I'm going to use. And she tells you that in the video, but I'm going to use my taco seasoning. If you're interested, I have a video on how to make your own seasonings and mixes. Taco seasoning is one of them. You're going to need a half a teaspoon of taco seasoning. Now, you can adjust these to suit your needs. Hands down, you can add more taco seasoning, less. That meatloaf is one of those things you could add less or more of ingredients, with the exception of a couple things. Like the bread, you want to keep that. Bread and the eggs, you want to keep that pretty much standard. It's kind of like 1 egg per pound of meat, 1 cup of bread to your meat. And play a little. Those are your binders. So we'll put our teaspoon of taco seasoning. I'm sorry, your half a teaspoon of taco seasoning in there. And then we're going to take the eggs, set them aside real quick. All right, so right here on this, I have 1 medium onion, finely diced. Okay, I know they're still sticking together because it's wet, but 1 medium onion, finely diced. We've got hidden in there about 1/3 of a bell pepper, medium to small bell pepper. And then I've got 1 celery stalk, okay? And those are all finely diced up. You want them, most of the time I'll tell you, you chop them up as big or small as you want. And you can still do that with this. But the way she was making it, you don't want it to be like super chunky. You just want the flavor more than the texture. So by dicing them up real small and putting them in as it cooks, you know, just no different than cooking any of this in a pan. They turn translucent, they soften up, and they become part of the meatloaf instead of, you know, a textured part of the meatloaf, which is kind of cool. So we got 1 medium onion, 1/3 of bell pepper, and 1 celery stalk, fine diced. And we're going to pick that up, and we're going to throw that all in there. All right, so we got all that in there. Then we're going to take 2 garlic cloves. If you have small ones, you can use 3, but I have ginormous garlic cloves, 2 garlic cloves, And the tool I had to go get is my garlic press. Now, if you don't have a garlic press, that's fine. You don't absolutely need one. You can just simply dice it up. Matter of fact, this garlic clove is so big that I'm going to need to cut it. So I'll just go ahead and cut it in half. I'm lazy. I don't like to mince garlic. That's what they created a press for. So I'll go ahead and get this pressed in real quick. All right, there is that. Got that in there. We need a knife or something like that so we can cut it off the bottom. Yeah, pressing it is, in my mind, the same as mincing it. I mean, you do get a little more of the flavor bursting out of it this way, I think. And anything that, like, you know, inside here, it's not minced. But that's okay, it'll fall apart, I promise. So we got our two garlic cloves in there, minced. If you don't have fresh garlic, you can also use jarred garlic, like you would buy at the grocery store, little jars of already minced up garlic. Then we're going to add our two eggs. We'll add our Worcestershire sauce. And then last but not least, we'll throw in our breadcrumbs and milk. I mean, see, it soaked it up real nice. It's not drippy or anything like that. It's just, you know, got a mix in it. Yeah, it's wet, you know, not ooey gooey, just wet. Put that in there, and then we're going to mix this up. We're going to use our hands. That's right. Make sure your hands are clean. You know, you don't want to be out working on a car or, you know, picking your nose and then mixing the meatloaf. That'd be kind of gross. You would get all that stuff in your meatloaf, it wouldn't taste very good. So you want to make sure your hands are clean. You know. Tell you one thing I did forget to put in here. Haha. I'm always good for not putting something in. So let me wipe my hands off real quick. I did not put the salt and pepper in. You want salt and pepper to taste. I am going to go with what is about the equivalent of a quarter teaspoon of each. Because salt and pepper you can always add on your meatloaf. We're not heavy salt eaters. I like pepper though. So I'm going to say maybe a quarter teaspoon of salt. And then a quarter to half a teaspoon of pepper. But you add what you like. What works for you and your family. You may not like all of that in there. Like I said, if it's not enough salt and pepper, I mean, if you've written this down, you can always when you eat it, you know, you and your family eat it, if you decide it needs more salt, more pepper, more of your seasoning, you can write it down in your notebook. You can say, okay, next time we're going to try this. One thing you don't want to do, you want to get this mixed good, but you don't want to over mix it. Okay, because it will turn to a real thick block in here, and then as your meatloaf cooks, it becomes denser. You know, it will become not, it's still edible, but and if you like your meatloaf dense like that, have at it. But I'm trying really hard to do it her way to see how, you know, it turns out. I have not had, other than my mom's recipe that she used to have, which was kind of simple, and I mean, not, it was good, but it didn't have a whole lot to it. And yeah, I have not had it since I was a kid, but I've not had a good meatloaf recipe in years. And like I said, I really wanted to make a meatloaf, and I wanted to do it from scratch. All right, so we got that all worked out and mixed up and ready to go. We're almost there. The hard part is going to be, breadcrumb there. The hard part's going to be cooking it, because it does take, you know, okay, so you probably got 10 minutes in prep work, as far as cutting up your celery, your onion, your bell pepper, and your garlic, if you're cutting it up or using your press. And then another 5 minutes dumping all your ingredients in, because you can just take it out of whatever you have it in, instead of putting it in prep bowls, unless you like that thing, I do. Mixing it together. So where you may have 15, 20 minutes getting here. Yeah, so this may not be a quick weeknight meal. That's a good weekend meal. Now we're just going to put this in our pan, all right, in our loaf pan. Nope. We don't want to leave anything out. Yeah. Every little bit of this is a tender, delicious morsel that's, you know, wanting to be your friend, so to speak. It doesn't know that you're really going to eat it. All right, we're going to kind of get it down in there. You know, get the edges. That's like, she had a loaf pan that was kind of designed for meatloaf. And I would like to get one, because I think it would be cool to have. I mean, not that I necessarily need one, obviously. I'm just using a regular old loaf pan. But her loaf pan was two pieces, and it had holes in the bottom of it. Well, one piece did, the inside piece did, and then you sat that down into a loaf piece with handles, an outer like loaf pan, and it let some of the grease drain off of it. But halfway through cooking, we're gonna pull this out, drain the grease off of it, and then put it back in there and let it finish cooking. Let me get my hands wiped off here. All right, there's that. All right, so we got our meatloaf made. The next thing we need to make is the glaze that's going to go on top of this. And it's a really easy glaze, but it looks like it's got lots of flavor. I'm not even a giant fan of ketchup glazes, but like a traditional meatloaf has, and this is a traditional meatloaf, but this actually sounds kind of good. I know growing up, it seemed like a thing in the 70s, to just put ketchup straight on the meatloaf. You would squirt your ketchup on the top and then let it cook with just the straight ketchup. But this isn't just straight ketchup. This has got some parts to it. All right, so it's got four things that go into it. First thing we'll need is a half a cup of ketchup, of course. Yeah. That's always good times. Half a cup of ketchup. One heaping quarter cup of brown sugar, and it's not packed brown sugar, it's just a quarter cup of brown sugar. Throw that in there. And then in this bowl here, we have a tablespoon of powdered mustard powder, and I don't know if you can see it or not in that deep corner there, but it's just a pinch. I mean, maybe like an eighth of a teaspoon of smoked paprika, and we're going to throw that in there. Obviously, that's one teaspoon of mustard powder and a pinch of paprika. And then the last thing we need to go in it is one tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce. All right, put that in there. Good there. Then we'll take our little whisk here, and we're just going to whisk that all together real quick. And like I said earlier, make sure when you start at the beginning of this to start preheating your oven 350 degrees. That actually looks really good and nothing like ketchup, more like a decent barbecue sauce. Matter of fact, I think I'm going to try it before I put it in on the meatloaf. Now, glazes are always optional on a meatloaf. I know most meatloafs that me and Chris make, we used to have a meatloaf flavor seasoning pack that we would get when we lived in Columbus. And I don't even remember now the name of the people who made it, but it was really good. We tried it one time and we were like, oh yeah, that's amazing. And that was pretty much what we used standard for meatloaf. I mean, it still took a few things to put in it. You put the seasoning pack in it, some ketchup, some mustard, some eggs, some breadcrumbs, and you called it a day. All right, we got that mixed up. Put it in the oven for 35 minutes, and it made you a nice 1 pound meatloaf. All right, so we'll take this glaze. I do want to try it first. Let's try it first real quick. That's really good. It's kind of sweet, but it tastes nothing like ketchup. And that mustard gives it, it almost tastes like a sweet barbecue sauce, which is kind of crazy. So we'll throw this over the top of it. Now as this bakes, we will, it'll form a crust like on the top of it. It won't stay exactly like this glaze and about, or like it is now. And we don't want to put all of this on here at once. We're just going to give it a light coating. And then, like I said, about halfway through baking of this, or cooking it in the oven, when we pull it out to drain it, because there's going to be grease that's going to build up along the sides and things like that. And we want to get that off of it, or you'll end up with just a greasy, messy, fall-apart meatloaf. But when we pull it out to drain some of the grease off of it, we'll put some more of this glaze on. All right, there is that. Set that off to the side. Wow, that glaze is really good. I'm totally impressed. I've not made a bunch of her stuff, but the stuff I've made of hers, the couple things I've made of hers, have been incredible. So, what are we going to do with this? I'm going to stick it in the oven, 350 degrees. Her instructions were for 55 minutes to an hour. Now, with this oven, we know that might not happen. So, I'm going to look for a temperature. I want a temperature, when I put my thermometer in the center of this, and you should do the same too, no matter what, when you check it. Meat, you should always check the temperature of your meat. The meatloaf, we want it to be between 160 and 165. So I'll just simply look for that temperature of at least 160. If it's above 160, I know it's done. So, I'm going to go ahead and put this in the oven. We're going to start at 55 minutes, and I'll start checking the temp at 55 minutes, and we'll temp it until it hits where it needs to go. So when I come back, we'll pull this out and get it out of its pan and try a bite. All right, I'll see you here in just 1 second. All right, guys, so we let that bake. It turned out to be about an hour and 15 minutes in my oven. I did find out something interesting, and it sounds like my world is falling apart out there. This oven that I'm about to only have until Wednesday, before we get our new oven, is about 20 to 25 degrees off. I cranked it up to 375 because I noticed it was just hovering around 300, but as soon as I cranked it to 375, the internal temperature of the oven came up to 350 and it finished cooking. I temped it with a thermometer. It temps at 161 degrees, so I know it's done. And if I would have pressed play earlier, instead of turning, I have the most amazing video that you guys probably won't ever see, or at least not all of it, of me singing and dancing in the kitchen because I thought the camera was off, and I actually turned it off when I turned it on to film this the first time. So what I did after I pulled it out and I temped it, I let it sit right here on the cooling rack. I got a cooling rack out. Let me bring it down to you. Right there, cooling rack, in all its glory. It is still a little warm, so I will bring it to you via the cooling rack. But there's our meatloaf. That glaze stiffened up real nicely. So what do we have to do next? Well, the next thing we have to do is get a plate to put it on. So I'll be right back in just a second. All right, due to the magic of television and me walking into the dining room to get a plate, we have a plate. So, we got that done. Actually, that's not quite as bad as I thought it was going to be. We will grab our offset spatula just to make sure it's off the sides. Now, halfway through baking this, I did pull it out of the oven and I drained the grease off of it. Yeah, that way there isn't a whole lot of grease under here. All right, so we got that and side off. Now, here's the tricky part. How do we get it out of the pan? Well, I don't know yet. I haven't gotten that far, but that's not that cooled down yet. So let's grab our towel so we can hold it. And we are going to try our best to not tear this up, bringing it out of the pan. There we go. All right. Yep, there's a little bit of grease left in the bottom of that. That's all right. That's to be expected with a meatloaf. You know, here's the thing with the grease. Now, let me explain that to you right quick. You don't want to drain all the grease out, because even though it's unhealthy, but there's nothing really healthy about meatloaf. That's also flavor and juices. But there we are out of the pan. I think that turned out quite nice. It did not fall apart. It did not break. Yeah, the glaze is good. It came right out of that pan. That was really nice. I don't normally when I cook a meatloaf, this is how much of a different experience this is for me. Normally when I cook a meatloaf, I don't put it in a loaf pan. I actually just form it similar to that. I stick it on a baking sheet. So if you don't have a bread pan, you don't have to use one. You can use a pie pan, a cake pan, just a regular cookie sheet and form it. And, you know, whatever you have available, it's there. You know, just like you can put any vegetable in it or no vegetables or, you know, whatever you guys like. But anyhow, enough of me talking. Let me grab my plate real quick because I'm just not prepared for this moment. Fine china, as usual. Tonight we're pairing this with potatoes, mashed potatoes. You could have rice with this. You could have butter noodles. You know, the side dishes are endless. You could have corn or broccoli or, you know, anything, a salad. I'm personally, with the potatoes, I'm also going to have a salad because there's some leftover salad in there from the other night that I would like to finish up so it doesn't go bad. But well, wow, that's hot. I don't know why I'm using my fingers. That's hot. Like I said, I let that rest in the pan for about 10 minutes. And even at 10 minutes, look at all that steam. I don't know if you can see the steam or not. There's a lot of steam coming off there. So let me grab a fork. And there we are, freshly cut. Not that it looks any different than it did right there. But it's in piece form. Now we're going to give it a taste and see how it goes. How goes it? Let me bring you up so that way I can look at you and you can look at me and we'll know whether or not it tastes good. Rachel's recipe did not disappoint. That has got a ton of flavor and that sauce that's on top is incredibly good. She wasn't wrong. I didn't think she would be. But this is an awesome recipe. And other than the weight to bake it or cook it in the oven, it's easy. It's so easy. So, that being said, for sure try this recipe. If you are, even if you're not a meatloaf person, you'll like this. I guarantee it. So give it a shot. Let me know what you think about it, because, man, you can taste, I don't even know what to say. I'll never go back to using a package for meatloaf ever again. That's an amazing meatloaf. Let me know if you try it. Let me know if you like it. You know, be like, Brian, this was amazing, because I think that's what you're going to say, because I'm telling you, it's amazing. Or if you didn't like it, be like, dude, my meatloaf is so much better. And let me know what you do. You know, I would love to know. Either way, let me know. All right, so today's Sunday. Tomorrow, nothing, it's Monday. Tuesday, we will do a talk. Wednesday, I will cook dinner because we're going to cook in my brand new oven. As long as it shows up, it's supposed to be here between 7 a.m. and 1 p.m., so we should have plenty of time to cook, but I'm not sure exactly what we're going to cook yet, but we'll figure something out. Heck, we may try a pork chop recipe. Who knows? And then Thursday, we're going to try to bake something in this bad boy. So, I don't know what that's going to be yet, but I got my mindset kind of on a cake. I just don't know what kind yet. Might be a peanut butter chocolate cake. Who knows? Who knows? But we'll take it as it goes. I'll let you know more on Tuesday about Wednesday and Thursday. And I hope you guys have a good rest of your day and tomorrow. Until then, I'll see you Tuesday. I love you. I love you very much. Tell somebody else you love them and you love them very much. Going to make their day a whole lot better. It's going to make you feel a whole lot better. I guarantee. It makes me feel great to tell you guys how much I love you. Till then, I'll see you Tuesday. All right? Love you. Have a great day. Bye.